recently, I've been getting paranoid about how black I am, right? No, when I say how black, I don't mean like literally, I can see that. I mean like deep down in my soul, I've been getting paranoid about my blackness, right? I don't even know if there's even such a thing as blackness. I don't know why I'm looking at three white girls, sorry. Yeah, it's online, innit? Yeah. Mm. TimWestwood.com. No, I don't know. But no, I'll be getting paranoid. But the reason why I'll be getting paranoid about my blackness is because in the last like 18 months or so, I've done quite a bit of work on BBC Radio 4, right? Now, for anyone here who doesn't know BBC Radio 4, a young black guy appearing on BBC Radio 4 is a bit like 50 Cent making a guest appearance on Midsummer Murders. Right? Very white middle-class radio station, right? But they've given me work, and I've taken it. And recently, my agent called me up, said, hey, Nathan, I've got some news for you. There's this TV producer, he's heard you on Radio 4, and he thinks it's very funny. He wants to have a meeting with you to discuss maybe doing something on TV. So then, just as a joke, I said, what? He wants to put me on television. Doesn't he know that I'm not white? Just a stupid joke, playing on the whole myth that in comedy, if you're not white, you don't get a fair opportunity, okay? I didn't mean anything by it, just having a laugh. Often my agent would see it as a joke and go, ha ha, Nathan, that's very funny. I'll book the meeting for you. Instead, my agent, who's white, she went, oh, don't worry about that, Nath. The amount of Radio 4 you've done, you're virtually one of us now. Get paranoid, man. I get paranoid about so much stuff, it's unbelievable. Like also in the last few months, I started getting paranoid about terrorism, right? I never used to. I used to have a very British attitude towards terrorism. Because in Britain, we don't take terrorism as seriously as we should do, right? It's a fact. Like there was the Boston bombs and a marathon. And I'm not laughing at that. That was horrific. But what I noticed, about 5 days afterwards, there was a London marathon. And I remember they were telling people who were travelling down to London, they were like, if you're going to go to the marathon in London, just be careful, all right? After the events a few days ago in Boston, just be on your guard. But British people, were we scared? Were we, fuck? Unless those bombs are made of snow, they can fuck off. Because that's the one thing we are scared of in this country, isn't it? Snow, you know? Terrorism, fuck off. Bombs, fuck off. Snow, hey, that's slippy, bruv. Look at that, man. That's suicide, isn't it, bruv? I've been getting paranoid about terrorism. The reason why is because there was an incident which happened in Kenya in the shopping centre, which again, I'm not laughing at. But what scared me about it was after it happened, the Kenyan government put out a worldwide wanted alert for who they thought was a ringleader. I don't know if anyone saw who it was. It was a white woman. Her name was Samantha Luthwaite. Her nickname was the White Widow, right? And that scared the shit out of me. Seriously, when the most dangerous and wanted person on the planet is a white woman, something is terribly wrong with the world, man. Like, is there no one we can trust anymore? Like, even white women are now a threat to security, right? I'll be honest, ever since then, white women have been starting to scare me. Now, like the other day, me and my brother, who's 18, we're on our way home from a football game, and we're walking down a particularly dark street. And then I noticed there was a white woman walking towards us. I'll be honest, I fucking shit myself, man. Like, what sort of twisted backwards world are we now living in when two black guys and a white woman by herself are walking towards each other down a dark street and the two black guys cross the road, man?